Hey traders, Nick from Vant Trading here with another lesson plan. Today I'm going to be talking about something very important, and if you're going to be day trading, hell, even if you're going to be investing or swing trading part-time with your own accounts and your own money, this is something you need to know, because this is something that could save you a lot of money and a lot of headache, and it could prevent you from scratching your head wondering, well, why can't I trade? What is going on with my positions? Today, in the wake of GameStop's craziness, AMC, and a lot of the low float healthcare stocks we're seeing go crazy, this is something that I need to address because some of our viewers do not know about this. It is called the circuit breaker stop and the limit up, limit down rule. What I'm going to be talking about is how the stock market and individual stocks can be halted for trading. I'm talking for minutes, hours, days, weeks, or even months. We've seen stocks halted for years and never reopen. So I'm going to be trying to go through this quickly. I'm going to give you a little bit of history on what this is and why it was brought into effect. Is this good or bad? I'm going to be giving you two perspectives. One, what causes the entire stock market to halt trading? What are the rules that you need to know? And then two, what is the limit up down rule, and what is that gonna, when does that come into effect with a stock, and how does that halt trading, and what could that mean for your positions? What if you're in a stock that halts trading? All right, so let's kick it off. I don't want this to go too long. So first of all, the circuit breaker halt. This is something that can happen in the stock market. It's happened before. It's happened before recently. And it really began, give you a brief little history, in 1987. On October 19th, 1987, the Dow Jones Industrial Average fell 22.6% in a single day. It all started in Hong Kong. There was a little bit of a crisis there, and it went worldwide. It was called Black Monday. And if you want to see what the stock chart looks like, bam, there's the SPX, is the S&P 500 on that day. Look at those look at that tanking that we saw in 3 days. I mean, it was astronomical, and that caused people to worry, well, what happens? You know, how can we protect against this? And so they started thinking about circuit breaker halts, in which case, if the market goes down a certain amount, they shut down trading for a certain amount of time. Now, we had another little crisis in 1997. This was a little bit of a mini crisis. It was an economic crisis in Asia that started again, and it caused a little mini crash. October 27th, 1997, that's what it looked like right there. This was kind of the first time that this came into effect. Trading was halted briefly, wasn't halted all day, but they halted trading for, I believe it was 10 minutes, 15 minutes, just to kind of let things work themselves out, let people calm down, assess the news and not panic, and then that way when the market reopens, then they're allowed to hopefully make rash and intelligent decisions. Then we had a flash crash May 6th of 2010, and in this case, the Dow Jones dropped 9%, it's 9% in 10 minutes. However, the current way that the circuit breakers were set up, it didn't stop trading. And so a lot of people were worried, and they were like, all right, we need to develop some rules. And so finally, we saw these rules enacted in 2020. Yes, the market halted trading twice in 2020, and that was the last time we've seen it, and the first time since 1997, and I want to talk about it. First of all, let's talk about this market-wide circuit breaker threshold. What is the threshold? What happens? And so what happens is there are three levels. And I'm going to give you a little graphic just so you can kind of read along. There's level one, level two, level three. And this is all based on the previous day's close of the SPY or the S&P 500. So you need to know what that previous day's close is. So if the S&P 500 goes down 7% in that day from the previous close, they halt trading for 15 minutes. Unless it's after 3:25 p.m. Eastern, they don't want to halt and give you no time to get out of positions once it reopens going into the close. So if it's after 3:25 p.m., trading continues. Now we have a level two halt, where if now we've passed that level one halt, we've gone down 7%, we've halted trading for 15 minutes, the SPY now goes down to 13% down. They halted again for 15 minutes. Again, same rule with that 3:25. Then let's say, oh my God, something serious is happening. The market goes down 20%. They will halt trading for the remainder of the day. There is now a rule in place where if the stock market goes down 20%, the trading is halted market-wide for the day. Going to be important to note. Now, you know, hopefully this never comes up. Hopefully this is never something that you have to deal with. And it's not from the open. Keep that in mind. It's from the previous close. So gaps matter. Overnight price action matters. So if I pull up the price action from the beginning of 2020, you remember the coronavirus, obviously, still sitting here, still bothering us. Well, here you go. And I've pointed out the days here where we had those halts. Those days don't look like we dropped that hard. But look at the gaps we saw, the overnight price action. From the previous close up here, we gapped down astronomically to the extent that the market hardly had to drop to enact that level one halt threshold. So that's what we saw, and we actually saw the stock market halt trading for only 15 minutes, but still, it was the first time we'd seen that since 1997. So that's what the market-wide circuit breaker is. It's something that we rarely see, but it's something you need to know about and need to be aware about, because if it hits those level two rules, then you need to know, well, 20%, it's shutting down for the day. Just something to keep in mind, unless it's after 3:25 p.m. Now let's talk about single stock price bands. This is the limit up, limit down rule. This is a lot more applicable. I see this happen every single day. This happens hundreds of times in a day. Stocks are halted all the time. You may not believe it. You know, if you haven't been day trading that much, or you don't watch kind of those small price stocks or supernova stocks that go crazy, this actually happens all the time. And this is what this is. And this is an effort by the SEC, good old Security Exchange Commission, and the FINRA to address events like a flash crash. Now the market is 99% electronic trading and algorithms and computers. They're super fast. If something happens and the market starts dropping, those computers will pull their bids, pull their orders a lot faster than you, and that will cause securities pretty much market-wide to flash in, you know, crash in a flash. That's why they call it a flash crash. We've actually seen several of these, and it's been interesting to watch. And so what they want to do is they want to keep these individual stocks from going down too crazy and crushing the investors, crushing everyday traders, and having people have to react to a headline on a blink or worry about their position being down 50% in a minute. So this is kind of what they're trying to combat there. The halts are generally, if a stock halts with this limit up, limit down, and I'll talk about the threshold in a minute, typically they halt a stock for trading for 5 minutes, and then the stock will reopen and resume trading. Now, there's some caveats I want to talk about. Now, how are these price bands, this limit up and limit down, calculated? Because it's not based off the previous close like in the market. You know, you have to take into account, you know, a stock could gap up because of news or gap down because of news. Now, instead, it's this. So what happens is there's a price band that they calculate. And what they'll do is there's tier one and tier two stocks. And this may look a little weird. You can pause this and look at it a little more if you need to. And this doesn't fully encompass all of the rules. There's all these different rules. I don't want to get too complex here. But if it's over a $3 stock, keep that in mind. You know, what they're going to be doing is they're going to be taking an average of the last 5 minutes constantly rolling. So every second, you know, they're taking that average further, what the average executed price of the stock was. So if, say, the stock has been trading at $100 a share over the last 5 minutes on average, then that for a tier one stock, and that's what 99% I think of the stocks are tier one, the price band is going to be 5% higher and lower than $100. So $105 and $95. What that means is that if that stock suddenly takes off or drops and hits those prices, they cannot go higher or lower than $105 and $95. Now, you know, they're going to need to go up there really fast to hit those prices, because remember, every second that moving average is constantly changing. So as the stock price ticks up to $101, $102, the average price is changing and the price band is rising with it. So this is really trying to combat really fast moves in either direction. And so what happens is if that price hits that band, if that stock price suddenly spikes from 100 to 105 or 195, and if those prices match and do not move for 15 seconds, they halt trading in the stock. So what I'm saying is say you've got the upper price band. You've got that 105. Now, if the best bid, which is the lowest possible price that someone's willing to buy it from you at, matches that 105 and won't drop for 15 seconds, then they halt it. And on the downside, you need the best possible ask, which is the lowest possible price that someone will sell you the stock. If that does not raise off of that 5% band, that $95 in this example, then they halt the stock if it's been matched for 15 seconds. So this is what happens. Now, they do take into account with over $3 stocks that if it's in the first 15 minutes of the day and in the last 25 minutes of the day, they understand that, look, most of the volume in a day is actually done in those times. It is very volatile. Stocks can be very volatile. So they actually double the band in this case. They give it 10% because they allow that price discovery, that volatility, the stocks moving back and forth. A lot of people are trying to figure out where the buyers and sellers are. So, you know, there's a little bit of volatility. But this is to combat stocks from going astronomically crazy or tanking 50% without people being able to react to the news in time and causing people to make rash decisions without properly analyzing the headline. They have these tier two for lower price stocks. You know, if it's from 75 cents to a $3 stock, then it's a 20% move. And then if it's below 75 cents, you know, we're talking penny stocks, you know, they have those parameters there. It's really that top tier up there, you know, all the way at the top, that top block, that's what most of the time you'll be seeing. And so that's kind of what it is. And so, like I said, every 5 minutes, you know, it's at this rolling average. So every second, they're recalculating that average price and they're taking 5% higher and lower. So that's something that you need to know. Now, if you have those bands, say you want to place an order at 110, and I'm like, I just want to see if I can get swept up there by someone making a mistake, it's not going to be a fillable position until that band goes past. Now, someone may ask, well, what about options? What happens if a stock is halted for trading and it has underlying options that you can trade? Options trading is halted as well. All of the derivatives and assets corresponding with that underlying stock are going to be halted as well. Trading as a whole is shut down and halted with that stock so that people can kind of figure it out and figure out what the hell's going on. Now, in the first 5 minutes, first 5 minutes of the day, what about the first 5 minutes of the day? The stock hasn't been trading for 5 minutes, so it doesn't have that 5 minute average. They take the opening print in most cases. Whatever that opening price was, that's what they stick it to, and that's where your 5% or in the first 15 minutes, that 10% band is going to be. And then after the stock has been trading for 5 minutes, now you have that rolling average, and now you know kind of where the average is of the day. So that's kind of where you are in that case. And a lot of times you might be able to see that level on your level two. It depends on your broker. It depends on the technology you have. So that's something you have to keep in mind. Now, in some cases, the maximum time a stock is supposed to be allowed to halt is 10 minutes. So keep that in mind. They typically try to force stocks open in 10 minutes. What could cause a stock to not open in those 5 minutes? Well, there's several cases, you know. Maybe the exchange itself is not ready. There's a lot of orders. You can still place orders while a stock is halted, by the way. You can place some limit orders around. You could place what's called a market on open, which means it'll buy or sell as soon as that stock opens. You could submit a limit on open. There's a lot of orders you could still place, and so the exchange needs to be pairing these and matching these and figuring out where the supply and demand is and what the price is going to be when the stock reopens. And so sometimes you might stretch that out from 5 minutes to 10 minutes. So keep that in mind. Now, there are a lot of really handy websites out there that you can go to find out what stocks are halted. For example, you can pull up NASDAQ actually has a wonderful website here. I'm going to drag it into the screen, and you can actually see all of the different stocks here that are halted. You can see the reasoning, limit up, the resumption date, the resumption quote time, when it was halted, what the stock ticker is, and the date. So you can actually get a lot of information there, which is really nice, and it's free. You just pull up that website. There are other types of resources out there that you can see that can help you with this and kind of figure out your information. Now, if you're in a position while the stock's halted, you know, prepare yourself. Get your orders ready. Figure out where this thing might open. Sometimes you can get some estimated opening times and some indicated reopening prices from Twitter, from several different resources out there. So that might be something you want to look into. So if a stock goes up and down really crazy, it can halt. Now let's show you some examples and show you why this can be really, really important. This is going to be our first stock example. And this one is pretty interesting. This is KOSS, K-O-S-S. This is one of the stocks that went supernova with GameStop and with AMC. It was squeezed up to infinity. And as it came back, every place you see an arrow here is a time the stock was halted. What that means that this stock went up 5% so fast and hit that price and wouldn't move from it for 15 seconds that they halted it. And then it reopened, hit that price immediately, and they halted it. Reopened, hit that price, they halted it. I'm not kidding. And you see these gaps, that's because there were so many buyers and sellers placing their orders and in the primary market getting ready and setting those orders that it ended up opening up at a different price. Yes, these stocks can open up at different prices, and this is where you can get hurt. Because look on the way down. Say you had bought this KOSS and it halted down and you're like, oh shit, suddenly this stock's tanking. I can't submit an order. I can't get out. It opens up lower. Suddenly it halts again. Oh God, it opens opened up lower, halts again. You know, if you're not prepared, you're not quick, and you weren't expecting something like this in a stock that's moving very volatilely during the day, you could get burned, and you can get burned really, really badly. And look at this gap. It gapped from almost $70 down to almost $40. That's a 30-point gap. And if you were long in here and you got caught on the halt, there is nothing you can do. And guess what? You opened up, and you opened up down almost 50% down overnight. So I hope, or in the matter of 5 minutes. And I hope you didn't put all of your capital into one position there, because that would have really hurt. So this is where something can get really crazy. And when we see a stock like this, we typically tell traders, don't touch it. There's no edge in here. There's really, really no edge. Now I'll talk about some ways that you could possibly trade halts, but I'll probably save that for another video. We're already getting pretty long. Let's look at another example here. This is a great example of GameStop. GameStop, when it finally rolled over, you've got a little halt in here, you've got a little halt in here, another halt here. You can see the gaps, you can see the moments where this stock halted on the way down. Now I want to show you one more, and this is an example from 2020 last year when Kodak blew up. This is an example where you really could have gotten burned. Look at this gap. So this thing opened up at 60. Yes, you have gaps all the way up, and then suddenly this thing stopped. We went from 50 all the way down to about 30. I mean, these things can just, as soon as people don't want it anymore, the rug is pulled, the bids are dropped, no one's bidding for this thing, it halts, no one's still bidding for this thing except for $30. And so this thing opens up at 30 because there's no more bids up here. No one's bidding for this thing any higher. And so that it has to open down there. And that's where you can get burned. So that's why I really wanted to address this. Now, there are other types of halts, so I want to address those real quickly just so you know what they are. There's a regulatory halt. The SEC can halt a stock for trading if they think there's manipulation, or if they need to conduct some kind of investigation. Maybe they have some serious questions that need to be answered about the company's assets, why the stock is going crazy, or something like that. We see that happen a lot with penny stocks when you get pump and dumps and a lot of manipulation. I'm not going to go into what those are, but you get that a lot where the SEC will literally just come in and say, hey, we're shutting it down. We need to know what's going on. We need to do a little bit of investigation. And those halts could take days, weeks, months. I've seen those halts last over a year. And the SEC actually keeps a list of these going all the way back to 1995. You can Google those and take a look and see, you know, what kind of stocks are we talking here and why were they halted? There's news pending halts. These can be halted prior to news releases. That means that the company calls the exchange up 10 minutes prior to releasing and says, hey, we need you to halt it. We're about to drop some news. And so what they do is they halt the stock. The company's allowed to drop that news. All of the investors and traders are allowed to now read that news, digest that news before they have to make a reactionary decision in the stock. This allows traders to, you know, take some time and make some intelligent decisions, hopefully, and it doesn't let the computers that skim the headlines just take the stock and run with it. So, you know, they do have their places. There are arguments against these types of halts. You know, some people say they're disruptive. They keep markets artificially volatile. I agree with that to an extent. You know, they can cause orders to build at that limit level and decrease liquidity. Computers will constantly be knowing where that limit order is, where that halt price is, and they could be setting orders up there, and they could be taking liquidity away to get to that price. A lot of people say that there's a magnet effect of these levels. That means that the closer they get to halt levels, the more likely they are to reach them and halt, because a lot of traders realize we're getting there. A lot of computer algos know that we're getting there. And so people then pile in and just make it almost become a self-fulfilling prophecy. That is very possible. You know, to an extent, this doesn't allow organic price action. So it is something to keep in mind. So look, you know, there's a lot of factors to consider there. So there are arguments, you know, for and against. You got to remember, 99% of the trading out there these days is computer and electronic. And, you know, there are arguments for, because look, if these computers suddenly read a headline they don't like, God knows how far and how fast some of these stocks in these markets could drop, and you will not be able to react in time. So the halting is supposed to try to help us. The fact that that halt could then cause a gap down, you're still probably not going to be fast enough to get out. So there is arguments that, you know, it's not as effective as people would like. I'm going to end it there. We're already on 20 minutes. I'm really sorry. I didn't want this to go that long, but this is a really important topic, because if you're day trading out there, you know, if you're investing, swing trading, you know, if it's a stock that's going really fast or really crazy, or they have breaking news that causes them to spike really fast, that stock could be halted for trading. And I don't want you to panic. I want you to know what's happening, how you can react. You can set orders ahead of time, prepare yourself, and really try to digest news. And yes, the market can be shut down market-wide. We've seen it twice in 2020. I'm sure we'll see it again. Now, this was Nick from Vant Trading. If this was any helpful at all, you know, drop a like, leave a comment if you have any further questions, you want me to dive in into any specific aspects here. And please, if you want any more notifications for our videos being posted, subscribe to our YouTube. You know, this is something that's just designed to protect you, to help inform you, because we need to be protective of our capital. And the name of the game is longevity in this market. So again, this was Nick from Vant Trading. I appreciate you tuning in. And as always, safe trading.